She was the first female to play professional hockey back in 1992, and now Manon Rheaume has a children's book that hit the shelves on Tuesday that chronicles that journey. It's called Breaking the Ice, and we are very happy to have her on with us right now on NHL Tonight. Manon, congratulations on all your success and the children's book that just came out. Tell us a little bit more about the children's book. We appreciate that it's a children's book because we can understand it and read it, but take us through that process, how you came up with the idea, and kind of going through the motions of putting that together.
Yeah, actually, Angie Bolero, she's someone that contacted me about 5 years ago about doing a movie on my story. She wanted a movie with a female lead and inspiring people. So when she reached out to me and she said that to me, right away when she mentioned inspiring people, I was in. And as we worked through with the movie, she was also a children's book writer, and she said, I need to tell your story too in a children book. So we started working on that too. So she would write the book and send me some information. She also spent 2 weeks with my parents. So she got all kind of insight from my parents. She got a chance to talk with Phil Esposito. So when she put that book together, she's a great writer, and it came out yesterday, and it was just so cool to see the book in the shelf, in the store now.
And of course, people know that you went to training camp with the Tampa Bay Lightning and face the shots and a full professional training camp. You mentioned in a little piece there that you were nervous. How nervous, can you remember what it felt like when you were presented the opportunity and then when it actually came time to go to the rink and get on the ice and get into a game?
Actually, when they invited me, when I saw Phil Esposito and he talked to me and invited me to the camp, I thought he was joking. And then he said to me, I'm going to send you a letter in the mail and you're going to have 2 weeks to respond. And when I got the letter in the mail, like, it was true, it was real. And I didn't think twice. A lot of people said to me, are you not crazy to look, you know, bad out there? You're just a small goaltender. You're going to play against men. And I told myself, you know what? I don't want to live my life with regrets and wondering 10 years from now, like, why did I not take this chance? So I went for it. And I remember that I walked to the locker room to the ice before my first exhibition game. Like, my heart was beating so fast. But the cool thing is, as soon as I stepped on the ice, the butterfly went away, and I was just playing a hockey game.
We see the picture over there, over your shoulder in the Bolts sweater. 28 years, I should say, after making that professional debut with Tampa. Do you think, I mean, you have a book out now, you've got a movie coming out. Do you think that story, your story specifically, is having more of an impact now than it did back in 1992?
Oh, absolutely. In 1992, people were just talking about the fact that I was a female, and some people said, oh, it was just for publicity, that's why she played in the game. And now people, when they talk about my story, it's more about, like, before Tampa Bay or Phyllis Gould said that I'm going to play in the game, I needed to perform in the camp. My first time on the ice, when I show up there, that was a small mini tournament, and I did not allow any goal in 14 shots. Actually, our team won 5-1, and I was the only goalie from the four goalie, two goalie in each team was playing. I was the only goalie not allowing any goal in that game. And I remember it's after that game that Phil Esposito said, the way she played today, you may see her in exhibition game. And I had to continue to play well in the camp to earn that exhibition game. And today, when people talk about my story, they talk about that part of it, where back then in 92, they were more slowly talking about, oh, she did that because for publicity, Tampa Bay got her there for publicity. So it's a big difference the way they present the story now.
And I can attest firsthand, there'd be no friends in training camp. Like, there'd only be being nice to her. Like, everyone would be trying to score as hard as they could because they are also trying to make the
team. Yeah.
And they were not able to. Now, when you think back to growing up, obviously hockey's a big part of your family's life. Where did you envision yourself going with hockey? Did you ever contemplate an NHL exhibition game as part of your career goals?
I never thought of that, but I remember when I was about 11, I was to become the first girl to play in a Pee Wee tournament. So my first TV interview, one of the reporters asked me, do you think a woman can make it to the NHL one day? And like, I was 11 years old, and my response was, yes, maybe, if nobody tries to stop her.
Good answer.
Manon, some of the things that obviously you dealt with back in, you know, the early 90s and making it to the NHL as far as playing in that exhibition game with Tampa, some of the females in hockey are still dealing with those issues today. And, you know, it's fitting that we have you on right now because one of the trailblazers right now, Hillary Knight for the USA women's hockey team, had a pretty strong statement on social media the other day. I want you to listen to it and then we'll get your reaction on the back end of it.
Imagine how annoyed you'd be if you clarified that tonight you're watching men's basketball, men's hockey, men's football, men's rugby, men's lacrosse. Last night in the men's hockey game, I was surprised by how hard they hit or how fast they skated. In the men's basketball game, you should have seen LeBron James dunk. He can dunk. Maybe sports needs the distinction, but not in a more versus less kind of way. If you say women's sports, you say men's sports. If you talk about Sue Bird's 4 championships in basketball, she accomplished that in basketball. If you recap Alex Morgan's laser that went post and in, she was doing that while playing football, as we know here, soccer. If you see Kendall Coyne skating fast, she's not the fastest at women's hockey. She's one of the fastest skaters in the sport, and therefore the world. Billie Jean King isn't the GOAT because of all of her women's titles in tennis. She's one of the tennis greats, plus more. Get what I'm saying? We got this.
We do get what you're saying, because sports are sports, and we're guilty of it, too. We don't say men's hockey tonight. We just say hockey. How much conversation do you have with the women in today's game as far as what you went through, what they're dealing with, and how we as a society can take that step forward to be better in the realm of sports in general?
I can absolutely relate to that. Like, this is exactly what I dealt with when I was there in 92, the comment that people made about me. They were not talking about my performance. They were only talking about the fact that I was a female. So what she said totally, like, you know, I'm glad that she said that, and she's absolutely right. I look at a girl like Kendall Coyne. I had the opportunity to coach her when she was 12 years old, and she was one of the most amazing hockey players I ever coached. Determination, she worked so hard. I knew she would make it far. And, you know, just when she went and skated the fastest skater in the NHL All-Star game, it was one of the most amazing moments. And I can tell you, she could have beat a lot of guys out there, and it was great to see.
Manon, well, now you kind of think back. You have a book, you have a movie, you have a lot of stuff bringing your story back to the forefront. How often do you come across goaltenders, boys or girls, that you work with along the way, and you find yourself being an inspirational figure to them? And what does that mean to you?
It means a lot. Like Kim St. Pierre this year, she was at the Hall of Fame, and I did an interview with her. And one of the things she said is, you know, Manon was an inspiration for me. So to be there and to see this woman that was absolutely an amazing goaltender for Team Canada, that I inspired her when she was younger, and now she's in a Hockey Hall of Fame, is just one of the most amazing feeling. And it's probably what I... You know, if I said one of the most satisfying part of everything I did in hockey is I was able to inspire people.
All right, you're the female hockey coordinator for Little Caesars out there in Michigan. Also, I think you coached the U-12 team that's won 4 state titles. I want to know, when was the last time you put on the full gear, though, and played some hockey?
You know, when I play some hockey now, I put player gear.
All the goalies,
they
want
to skate out and score, right?
They just want to score goals.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Well, congratulations on all your success. We love telling your story. It continues to inspire today like it did back in 1992. The book is Breaking the Ice, children's book. Go and get it. It hit bookshelves yesterday. Manon, thank you so much for the time. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.